Okay, there's gonna be a video about, is this gun worth putting back to military? It's a Israeli Mauser, the sporterized stock. Actually, when I bought it, the stock that was on it was actually worse than this one, but this one I picked up later and put it on. When I first shot it, it wasn't that impressive. So I shot some groups with it yesterday, and I was going to put that video at the end of shooting videos, but then I noticed the shooting segment when I was using the hand loads got cut off because the camera's memory card was full, so I'll put this at the head of the video, and you can see the target, and if you want to watch the shooting parts, then fine, but I'll leave in the part with the hand load ammo because I still explain what the load is and stuff, so, this gun is kind of a neat gun. It's Israeli Mauser, obviously, but it's a SWP-45, which is like really, really late. And I think this one was never issued by the Germans because it doesn't have their proof marks. It's got like a Czech proof marks on it. And actually it has a bolt that has no guide rib that goes through the bridge here. So it's really a really late bolt. I don't think the bolt matches because it's been force matched to the gun, but kind of neat, has some neat features. They put like Model 98 on top of the receiver, and it has a 7.62 the Israelis put there, but it has the big trigger guard, stamped one. Actually, a lot of them have those, but the Israeli ones anyway. But so I figured, shoot some groups, see if it was worth buying a stock set for it. Because the amount of money I have into the gun, and then plus a stock set, it would still be cheaper than buying a complete gun in Canada right now. And it is in 308, so it's kind of nice that way. But groups weren't terribly impressive. This was 50 yards. And I think of some other excuses, like the sights are kind of shitty on these guns, or I don't like them that much. And the shooting conditions were not the greatest. And this is probably one of the poorer kind of targets I could have used. But there was some there, so I used it. But I should have been better off having like a square block to shoot at, because my aiming point was here at 6 o'clock. And I used Chinese ball ammo, which is like an M80 kind of rip-off ammo, that steel case stuff. So that's this group here. There's two there, one here, and two in the middle. It's not really that, like, these three here are pretty good, and then there's two down there, but so that group's not horrible, but here's the best group, which is the hand loads, 180 grain Hornady bullet, and I had like 4320 behind it. And there's five there, which is about, I think that's a 2-inch group, I think it was. These are an inch wide. So there's three of them in a pretty good little group there. The barrel's not perfect. It's a little bit, it's got this kind of weird, kind of really narrow rifling and then really big wide grooves. I think all the Israeli barrels are like that. And it's kind of pitted in the grooves a bit. The rifling are okay. It's not the best barrel I've ever seen, but it's not far from the worst. And then, so that was probably the best group of the day. They're the more consistent anyway. Like, this one was good for three of them, but then two of them kind of went weird. This group here was the same Chinese ammo, but I put match bullets into it up here. And I think that's the biggest group there, but it's, you know, four of them aren't bad, but might be more me than anything. But so that was the back sight set on 100 meters, aiming here. We've got these two groups. This one here, I moved the sight to 300 to get it up out of the way so it wouldn't get with these other groups. But that does still shoot quite high with the Chinese ball ammo. So it's like 1, 2, 3. It's like almost, it's like 4 inches high. Some of them, a couple of them are 2-3 inches high. So maybe it has a 300 meter barrel sight, guys. It shoots pretty much right on with the heavy bullets. just a bit to the left. But the front sight is to the left too, so I don't know, I have to do something with that. But I don't know, maybe the full military stock will make it shoot better. But it doesn't have all that barrel sticking out and stuff. Anyway, so yeah, so that's the groups, explanation, and I'll put the shooting parts after this, so enjoy if you want to watch those. If you don't, tune out now.
Okay, we're going to try a few groups here. I got a target at 50 yards with the Israeli Mauser, my sort of newer of the two. It's got a sporterized stock, so I was thinking, see how well to shoot. I shot it before, but I can't remember that it was that impressive, but see if it's worth getting a military stock for it or something. But that's some of the Chinese ammo we'll start with. Okay, that Chinese ammo was not very impressive, but it wasn't very accurate in better guns, so I'm going to try some hand loads. These are, let's see, 180 grain soft point Hornady, so they're like a flat base. 43.3 grains of 4320 Winchester large rifle primer. Only got five of them. I loaded up a long time ago. Okay, we're going to try one more thing. I got this Chinese ammo here, but I got, can't remember what the hell these bullets are. They're like Sierra match bullets or something. I think most of the accuracy problem with that Chinese stuff is the crappy bullets. But alright, we'll get the target and check the groups.